time I got that support, like, every time people clapped for me, every time they guys my tools, everything, all of those things I didn't see. Now, I wish I might have known that before. Like, I would have been happier.
I think that's super wise, right? And that's one of my favorite things about the fighting game community, and always has been, is just, right, seeing people from all over the place that have their own form of respect, their own form of disrespect.
Yes, goes
both ways. And finding those common ground and people they respect each other. And that's always one of my favorite things about the tournaments, is for as much as we all have favorites, right, like, the crowd is cheering for, they want a good match. When we're talking about, like, this is starting to get a lot, but when I saw your investment back into the community, one of the things that draws from that was super beautiful to me. It's a little time to get back, but you did a lot of great things to help players from VR go out and play and have a good place to play back home. But you raised the floor for everybody, right? You set expectations out of the place, and you really, not just a good thing or a good time, but you really helped. And that meant a lot to you. So that's what it's been one of the most meaningful parts of that over the years. It's been a lot of people. What is warm to back to the community? How do you want to think about your what do you want to accomplish? What do you want to do? You have to see your partner to look like in a few years.
This game, I've been thinking about this again. But what I'm going to do after I stop being a player, I know it's every player here, you know? But I've been thinking about this again. What am I going to do after I'm a player? Back to how it all started, and why did I start playing? And I realized it started being because I wanted to share with my friends that I was having fun, and to kick it together. And I realized, like, how big AMC has become a part of my life. It took a long time to after the pandemic. I was like, man, I'm home. I miss everybody. I miss the strangers that I'm gonna meet. And I just want the AMC to keep growing, and that more people can live the same experience that I've had. It's been so magical, you know, my life, all the people that I've known. And I want more people to know that there's a space that you can do that. You know, you don't even need to play violence, you know, because it's fun. I met so many people that just like to watch. They just like to watch. It's like being here. And the world needs that. The world has a lot of people that they're alone, and they want to be people that you can't find or can't find the meaning of what they're doing here in this life. And I feel like the FTC helped me, they gave me a space in life, and I want more people to find that, so I just wanted to grow more.
You're killing me here. But try to keep it together. I think that's incredibly powerful. Like, how do you judge that? Is it that by the performance? Like, what is progress look like?
Circles of people, you know, like, I have people from all walks of life, you know, people that, you know, they focus on me. So I was like, wait, why is my uncle talking to me about sports? Every time I see people get more invested into it, and I see, like, more friends that they don't know anything about finding and getting into it, it's like the world is good, people like it. And I feel like it's been growing. Look at this. Look at us, we're sitting here. I don't even know where my friends are. I think, I don't know where Tava is.
The whole room is full of friends.
It's full of friends and full of people that enjoy fighting games. This is progress. This is progress.
Yeah, that's how I think about it. I mean, there's numbers, but it's the feeling in the room. That's what I was I think trying to fight loneliness has been a big deal. But part of this, one thing that's a part of that, like, to avoid loneliness, you need different parts, different people, and different friends in your life, right? At some distance and closer. What about the friend? How important does that affect you? Did your parents support what you were doing?
No, at the first I don't know if most people do this, but academically I was already good. Like, I got to college when I was 15, and you know, I was projected to like, finish with the BM engineering when I was 19. So my parents were like, big, like, you know, this. This is the path we have set for you, and I think it's really good. And I was like, I don't like this. You know, maybe if I had the knowledge I have now, maybe it would have been different. But I'm glad it happened. You know, because life is not all about being safe. Life is not all about doing what you're supposed to do, but it's what you want to do. It's how you feel happy. And I feel happy here. You know? When they saw that, they love me. You know? So I said, you know, she's in the hospital taking care of something. And she sent me a text message. She said, oh, you got two perfects. And I was like, wow, really? My dad was like, you gotta pick up AP. My dad told me, like, my dad told me in 2017.
Is he right?
By the way? Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
I need it for a
okay, you said it's also 2017.
In 2017, he told me that, yo, if you don't win Capital Cup, if you don't make something out of this gaming thing, you could be like, I'm just gonna put you like in the military. You're gonna do something. And now he's talking to me about matchups. You know, it's.
So it started with threats.
Yes, I feel the support now, and I feel like everybody should always think like they have a balance. I need something safe, I need to survive, but I also need to be happy. I need to do things that I like, and I know that your circle, your friends, your family, they will be happy if you're happy.